Now, David Principe, an astrophysicist from RIT, thanks so much for coming on. Of course, we're talking about that meteor that was in Russia that injured so many people.
Yeah, almost 1,000, I think.
Yeah. So what can, you know, of course, when we see video like that, all of us wonder, could something like that happen here?
Well, you know, we're always worried about that sort of thing, but the unfortunate truth is these sorts of things do happen very often. An object this size, you know, has been known to happen maybe 10 times a year. The issue is that, you know, the Earth is very big and these rocks aren't that greatly large. So when they only happen around a populated area, that's when we find out about it. Most of the time they land in the ocean or in unpopulated regions where we just, you know, they don't know how it happens.
So it's not that this just never happens, it's just that we don't know about it because of where it falls.
Yeah, they certainly happen.
How often do we know, does something like this happen? I mean, this video is just shocking.
Yeah, I mean, I think there's been a couple studies that show that about 10 of these events happen per year. You know, space dust is not, there's a lot of things out there that kind of want to hit the Earth.
So what was it exactly? I know we say a meteor, but I don't think everybody knows exactly what that's made up of and where it came from.
Yeah, so essentially it's a big rock. I mean, what it specifically is made up of could depend on a lot of different things. But what it most likely is actually the original part of the solar nebula. So 4.5 billion years ago, the solar system formed, and there were lots of rocks and stuff forming during that time. And the things that didn't end up in planets ended up in comets and asteroids. And these sorts of things are revolving around the sun, just like the Earth is, but they happen to be much smaller. So these sorts of things are, you know, revolving around the sun for 4.5 billion years until at one point they happen to come in contact with the same path as the Earth, and we get a collision.
I see. All right. So is this something we should be worried about, concerned about? They usually break up before they reach Earth, right?
I mean, even in the case of Russia, it most likely broke up high above the atmosphere, and it was actually the sonic boom that caused the most amount of destruction and not an actual impact of any physical object. But the Earth's atmosphere is very good at protecting us, even though we're not very good at protecting it.
That's another story. We'll do another
time. That's a different time, yeah.
All right. Thank you so much for coming on. We appreciate your expertise on this.